Today, let's talk about useful keyboard shortcuts and boot modes and features every Mac has to help you restoring your macOS or troubleshooting your macOS, installing a fresh one, and especially if you're installing an unsupported macOS on your old Mac. And that covers a safe mode when you cannot log in anymore, a verbose mode when you see all the details, what's happening during boot, and you have to pinpoint the problem, the different kind of restores that the Mac can do, the newest macOS and the oldest one, and for instance, like a target disk mode where you can use your Mac as an external hard drive, maybe if the screen is not working anymore, but you can get your data back. So let's start. But first of all, I'd like to give you a hint to our sponsor of the video, and that is Clean My Mac X. And especially if you're running into trouble with your macOS. You had done a lot of projects, so there's a lot of stuff piling up that is not needed anymore and slowing your Mac down. And Clean My Mac X can just clean your Mac, as the name says, and get rid of all the junk, and you really see that it's getting faster and more smoother work with your macOS. And especially with Black Friday now coming up, there's a perfect Black Friday offer. It's a 30% off. All the links are down in the video description. So before we start, we have to differentiate between the new Macs with the Apple Silicon, that means the M1 or the M2 chips, and the older Macs that have Intel chips, like an i3, i5, i7, or i9. And depending on what Mac you have, you use, there are different shortcuts. Basically, for all new Macs with Apple Silicon, just keep the power button pressed during start. Don't release it, just keep it pressed, and then you will see this startup screen where you get the gear that says options. And a lot of options that the Intel Mac users have to do with different shortcuts are behind this gear. So let's go through the shortcuts, and the first most important shortcut is the Apple Boot Selector, where you can select from which partition or hard drive or external USB drive you want to boot. And especially for those guys installing an unsupported macOS, they need the EFI boot partition of the open core of the bootloader that starts the new macOS that is officially not supported. And how to do that? As I said, with the Apple Silicon, you just keep the power button pressed and then you see the boot selector, you just select the partition you want to boot and it boots. For Intel Macs, you have to keep the option key pressed. And one important info, if you have an older Mac, like this one here, like the old MacBook Air from 2013, the key was called Alt before. So if I'm talking about an option key, that means the Alt key on an older keyboard. If you just keep the option or Alt key pressed, you will see the boot selector without the gear, that is only Apple Silicon, and then you can select the partition or the drive you want to boot from. Here on that screen, you can also set the standard boot option that your Mac always boots from if you don't select anything else. For Apple Silicon, you just keep the Alt or Option key pressed, and for Intel Mac, you keep the Control key pressed. And then you see this little upward arrow below the icon that is now selected changes into an arrow that makes a circle. And if you now keep this key pressed and select this option, then your Mac will always select this as a standard boot option. One more thing here on that screen, if you select a boot option and then you keep the shift key pressed, then your Mac boots this option into the safe mode. And in the safe mode, it doesn't load all drivers if you maybe have a driver that's causing trouble, and you just might be able to log into your macOS anymore, which maybe was not the case before. You will see that in the top right corner, there is a red writing called safe mode. And when you just shut down your Mac and reboot it again, then it will just try to boot into the regular mode again. So this is just a temporary mode that you activate when you keep the shift key pressed. If you don't go into the boot selector, you have your standard boot set or only one boot option, it's fine. Just switch on your Mac and keep the shift key pressed, and then it will just boot into its standard boot mode
as a safe mode.
And the last feature that it has here on the boot selector, it is the verbose mode. The verbose mode just writes everything on the screen, what is happening normally behind the curtain during boot. So if your Mac hangs during boot, you can activate the verbose mode so you can see what was the last entry or is there maybe an error message, and then you can pinpoint your problem. To activate the verbose mode, this is just Command key and V for verbose. This also works when you don't go into the boot selector, you just switch on your Mac, same as with the safe mode, just keep Command V pressed, switch it on, and then it boots your standard boot option, your regular macOS, into the verbose mode. Same as with the safe mode, as soon as you switch off your Mac and switch it on again, the mode is gone. You have to do that every time you want to do and have the verbose mode. If you suspect a hardware error on your Mac, you can boot into the Apple Diagnostics tool. How to activate the diagnostic mode? Just keep the D key as diagnostics pressed and then switch your Mac on. If you get an error message, try Alt or Option D, and that will activate the online diagnostic tool. So you need a Wi-Fi or an Ethernet connection, and then it will download the diagnostic tool and then do the hardware diagnostics. One of the most handy keyboard shortcuts that you might need is the reset of the NVRAM or the PRAM. And just up front, this is safe to do. You don't delete your data or anything important. There's just a little storage here on the main board of every Mac that saves some variables. For instance, when you do the reset, you will experience that the chime up in the beginning is quite loud because the volume setting is set in that NVRAM and this one is deleted, and then it starts with full volume. So if your Mac becomes a little bit slow or you have trouble with anything, I would try this first. And especially if you're using OpenCore or maybe you had a patched macOS, then you should reset NVRAM before you do a new and fresh install. How you do that? It's a little bit more complicated. It's four keys at once. It's Command, Option or Alt key, and then R and P. And you can remember that it means reset PRAM. Just keep that pressed, switch on your Mac, and then wait until you hear the second chime. You hear the first chime, you will see, okay, now it's doing a reset and it just resets, starts from the beginning. Then you hear normally the loud chime because the volume setting is deleted. And when you hear that second chime, release the keys and then it should just boot automatically into your macOS. So what might happen is that you see the no entry sign when you did the reset and VRAM. Don't panic. Just start your Mac again, keep the Option Alt key pressed, and then select your macOS again where you want to boot. For instance, if you have an unsupported Mac, you now have to choose the EFI boot option and then your macOS. So OpenCore loads the unsupported macOS. One more reset that you can do to maybe troubleshoot your Mac, again, you don't lose any important data or you don't wipe your hard disk, is the reset of the SMC, the System Management Controller, only for Intel Macs. To reset that, you just use the Option or the Alt key, the Control key, and the Shift key. Keep those keys pressed and switch on your Intel Mac, and then it will reset the SMC. It's kind of like the PRAM or NVRAM. There are some variables stored in there. You can reset that and see if your Mac now boots smooth and works smooth again. Now let's talk about the different kinds of recovery you can do on your Mac. If you run into trouble and your macOS is not working anymore, you can do the recovery. And basically, if you do a recovery, your data remains on the hard disk and in macOS. It just tries to recover to reinstall the macOS again and maybe therefore eliminate the error that you had. It might happen that this doesn't work, so try to do a backup of the data first, like a Time Machine backup, or copy it on a USB drive. If you want to do a fresh install, In the recovery mode, there's also the hard disk utility where you can wipe your hard disk completely to do a fresh install of macOS. This recovery option started with the MacBook Pro from 2012, that is the MacBook Pro 9.1 or 9.2, and then the Retina versions 10.1 and 10.2. And afterwards, Apple just retrofitted some older models with updates to be able to do the internet recovery as well. And that is the 2011 and the 2010 MacBook Pro, as well as the MacBook from 2010, the MacBook Air from 2010, the Mac Mini from 2010, and the iMac from 2011 and 10. So basically, nearly all Mac models from 2010 and younger should be able to do that. And there are different types of recovery that you can do. The first one is just an offline recovery of your currently installed Mac. If there's no recovery partition, this one will connect to the internet as well and try to recover your actual installed macOS. And that is easy. You just keep Command R for recovery pressed and switch your Mac on. Then it should enter the recovery mode. It takes 3, 4, 5 minutes until the recovery option goes up, and then you can either wipe your hard disk or just do the recovery like with a regular Mac OS install. If you want to do an online recovery of the newest Mac OS that is officially supported on this Mac that you are using right now, you can just extend that keyboard shortcut, and that is Command and then Option or Alt key and R. So you add the Option or Alt key. Then it searches for the latest official supported Mac OS and installs this. So you just don't need to download it up front and create a USB drive or whatever. Just do this recovery and then you can use the latest macOS. The opposite of that is that you can install the oldest available macOS. To activate this function, you just add the Shift key. So you have Command, then you have Option or Alt, Shift and R. And then you will see the fancy install screen of a very old macOS. In this case, it's macOS, I think, Mountain Lion or Lion. Looks quite different than the new modern macOSs, but it's kind of a nice feature that the Macs have if you wanna ever try out the very first macOS and how quick the old macOS runs on your old Mac. One handy feature that every Mac has is that you can set it into a target disk mode. What does it mean? You basically connect it with a USB cable with another Mac or with a Thunderbolt cable. And by the way, if one of those two Macs have installed macOS 11 Big Sur or newer, you definitely need a Thunderbolt cable. And then you can set the other Mac into a target disk mode that it acts as an external hard drive. Just keep the T key as target key pressed, then switch your Mac on, and then you will see this little flash here. It's in a target disk mode, and then you can access your files from the other Mac. Maybe if the screen is not working anymore on a MacBook or on an iMac, or you just cannot boot anymore, you can try to access the hard drive of your Mac from another one. At the end, some handy shortcuts within macOS, as we're now talking all about boot modes, is if something happens in macOS. Maybe your mouse loses the Bluetooth connection, or nothing works anymore because one application is stuck. So you can force quit the application. And that is easy. You just use Command, Option or Alt key and Q for quit. And then without any questions, this application is quit. Another handy combination is if you lose your mouse and you want to restart or shut down your Mac, and you cannot reach the Apple in the top left corner, just use Control and then press the power button or the eject button that it's in the very top right corner of your keyboard. And then the dialog will show up with restart, sleep, and shutdown. And then you can just use the keyboard to restart or shut down your Mac. If nothing helps, you can force restart your Mac with a keyboard command, but careful, this doesn't save any open files. If you have a spreadsheet or a document open, unsaved, this will not be saved because it just force restarts your Mac. And that is Command, then Control, and then the power or eject button. Be careful, this goes quick. You just press it and your Mac is restarting. And one last additional tip that I can give you is how to do a screenshot on your Mac in macOS. You can use tools for that, obviously, but it has an integrated screenshot function. And that is just Command, Shift, and 3, the number 3 on your keyboard. This takes a screenshot of your whole screen. If you just want a part of the screen, then you just use the Command, Shift, and 4, and then the mouse pointer changes, and you can just drag one part of the screen that gets into the screenshot, and the screenshot is then saved on your desktop. Thank you very much for watching. I hope these commands helped you a little bit. If you haven't yet, I would recommend you subscribe to the channel and click the bell for notification so you don't miss any news or updates about macOS Ventura, about OpenCore, the legacy patcher, or some problems that might arise, where I can warn you, maybe don't do this update yet on your unsupported Mac. Have a lot of fun here on my channel. I invite you to go through the other videos here. You can learn a lot about unsupported Macs, about flying, about like model flying. I built a very large RC C-160 cargo plane. Whatever. Have a lot of fun here. See you soon. Bye-bye.